So that's the moon. Time to bring the other player into the picture, and that is the sun. Now, the Earth goes around the sun, right? And the sun causes tides as well. And so here's the Earth going around the sun, and that orbit is not perfectly circular either, right? It's elliptical, but the eccentricity of that ellipse is somewhat smaller. It's only a 4% difference between the closest and the furthest away. And as I said before, the axis of the Earth's rotation is tilted compared to the plane of the orbit around the sun, and that's what gives us the seasons. We have the winter solstice is the 21st of December, right? And then the equinox, when the days and the nights are the same length, 21st of March, and then the summer solstice, 21st of June, or thereabouts. It varies sometimes from one day to another. So yeah, this 4% difference between perihelion and aphelion will have a small effect on the solar tide. But what is the period of the solar tide? We established that the lunar tide would be 12 hours and 25 minutes. What about the solar tide? It's actually pretty simple because it's half a day, right? A day is defined as the time between when the sun's in the middle of the sky and then when it comes back around to the same position, which is 24 hours. And that's what we're interested in for this gravitational bulge which points towards the sun, right? So the solar semi-diurnal tide will be exactly 12 hours, or thereabouts, okay? Because again, we have this Kepler effect, right? Which nobody talks about. You have, your watches are set so that they will always run a day for 24 hours, and that's what you call Greenwich Mean Time, okay? Anyone ever think about what GMT actually means? Greenwich Mean Time. The M there stands for mean, and it's because in reality, the days are not all the same length. The days are not all 24 hours. And we just ignore that because it would be very inconvenient. The mean there is because of that, because of this Kepler effect and how sometimes the Earth's moving faster around the sun than at other times. And when it's moving faster around the sun, the actual day is a bit longer because it takes a bit longer to get back facing the sun again, right? So when we're closer to the sun, around the 3rd of January, the days are actually longer. I'm not talking about the sunlight time. I'm talking about the entire 24-hour day. It's actually more than 24 hours. And then when we're further away, it's less than 24 hours. So that will affect the tidal frequency for the solar tide. Now, let's put the two together. And so we have these two different frequencies. I showed you the interference between those two frequencies, 12 hours and 12 hours, 25 minutes. That gave you this modulation. So twice a month, you have these strong tides, and then twice a month, you have the weaker tides. There's a simple way of understanding that. You can just say, look, here's the sun, here's the moon, and here's the Earth. And the light blue bulge is the lunar tide, and the darker blue bulge is the solar tide. And in this configuration with the new moon, they are reinforcing one another, so they add together, and you get a strong tide. It's called a spring tide. A week later, the solar tide is in this orientation, the lunar tide, here's the moon, it's a growing half moon. They are cancelling one another out to some extent. Now, as I said, the lunar tide is stronger than the solar tide, so you won't get zero tide here, because the lunar tide will always win. It's about twice as big as the solar tide. But you'll get a weaker tide because they're cancelling. And then, full moon, a week later, they're reinforcing one another again. So there you go. Twice a month you get these strong tides, and then twice a month you get the weak tides. Yeah. So what do we mean when we say a month? What exactly do we mean? Well, here's the actual orbit of the moon around the Earth. I think that's a beautiful picture, right? Because you can see from the perspective of the solar system, the moon doesn't even go round. It just jumps like that as the Earth goes around the sun. And you see the Earth wobbles a little bit as it goes around as well. I think that's exaggerated, but so you've got this, what is that shape? Do you remember that shape from the first lecture? Remember when I got my bicycle and rolled it across the ceiling? It's the same thing. It's a trochoid on a circle. That just shows the beautiful coherence of my lecture course, doesn't it? That we've come back to the orbital dynamics and we've got the same shape as a surface wave at the beach. And so how long does it take for the Earth to move that distance of one moon orbit? Well, the moon goes around the Earth in 27.3 days, right? But in the meantime, the Earth has moved. So relative to the sun, the moon has to go another couple of days to 29 and a half days to be in the same phase again. So the phases of the moon change on a period which is about 30 days, 29 and a half days. Right? So the time between a new moon and a full moon, the time between these maxima in tidal amplitude is about 15 days.